dreaming of you more. You're always hoping that we make it. You always wanna keep my gaze, but you're the only one I see. And that's the one thing that won't change. I will never stop trying. I will never stop watching as you leave. I will never stop losing my breath every time I see you looking back at me. And I will never stop holding your hand. I will never stop opening your door. I will never stop choosing you, babe. I will never get used to you. To you, it's not a momentary phase. You are my life, I don't deserve you, but you love me just the same. And as the mirror says we're older, I wanna look the other way. You are my life, my love, my only, and that's the one thing that won't change. I will never stop trying.
Hello. Sorry.
I've waited 100 years, and I'd wait a million more.
To be wed today.
Mother not.
All right. You can be seated.
Hey,
Well, on behalf of the families and all of us up here, we would like to thank you for being here. Obviously, you took your time to come out on a weekend and celebrate with us, and so we are beyond grateful for that. As I would always tell any person in a huge moment like this, take an opportunity to look out and see the people that are here and just take the moment in, because this will be something you're going to want to try to look back on and remember. So whenever you see these faces and when you talk to them later on, just remember who came, supported you, and that's something we should be extremely grateful for. So if you'll just bow your heads and we'll get a prayer going here. Father, thank you so much for letting us be here today. This is something that is extremely important. It's something that's extremely valuable, and we're more than happy for Ethan and Nicole that they're choosing to enter into marriage, that they're choosing to follow the covenant that God has placed before a man and a woman to come together and be married. We just pray blessings over them. We ask that you would be over their lives, that you would guide them, and that you would be the ultimate and primary focus of their lives and the direction they go. So we pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, we're here. We made it. So I generally, whenever I've done this in the past, I like to at least talk a little bit about the bride and the groom, and I've known you both for a little while now. Obviously, you have been together as long as some married people have. If anyone here doesn't know, they've been doing this since high school and beyond, so we've finally made it to the point of where we're going to make this official. You know, 10 years ago, they might have called it Facebook official, and now we're just actually going to call it getting married. So that's where we've come from to this point, and now we're here today, and it's extremely exciting. And so whenever I thought about what I would speak on whenever y'all had asked me to do this, there was a few things that went through my mind. Obviously, there's some scripture that I'd like to share with you, and there's some things that I think I would like to give you as far as wisdom that has helped me in my life, as far as my marriage and just the general process of being in a relationship with another person and caring deeply for that person. As far as scripture, there's tons of scripture on marriage and on love, and you can go to any wedding and you can hear just about all of them, and you probably have heard most of them. The one that sticks out to me is in Ecclesiastes. It's in chapter 4. Essentially, I chose this scripture to read to you because I think it is the essence of what being married is about. And it basically says this. It says, "Two are better than one because they have a good return for their labor. If either of them falls down, one can help the other up. But pity anyone who falls and has no one to help them up." You're essentially getting that person. You are gaining the one that can actually be there for you when it is not ideal, when it is not good. And I think back on things, you know, as far as getting married, and I look to you two now. And one of my favorite authors is C.S. Lewis. And C.S. Lewis has quite a bit to say about love, and he has quite a bit to say about God himself. But there's an excerpt out of one of his essays, and it's called Being in Love. And it says, "Being in love is not merely a feeling, it's a deep unity, maintained by the will and deliberately strengthened by habit, reinforced by grace, which both partners ask for, they receive, and they get that from God. They can have this love for each other, and even at these moments when they do not like each other, they will still love." That is essentially one of the most important things I could possibly ever tell you as far as whenever you choose to get married. There's not always going to be days when you like each other, but you will definitely always want to pursue to love each other. And I don't say that, you know, humorously. I mean, I'm sure every married person out here probably gets a little fun out of that. But truthfully speaking, if you choose to love and you make a habit of loving and you make it a considerable effort every day to try to do that, I think you'll find out on the hard days that those days aren't quite as hard when it comes back around. Whenever you wake up the next morning, you're going to go back to that place. You always go back to the well that is full, and the well that is full comes from God himself. And that's why he says, he is love. It's the whole premise of why that's said in the scriptures. So all that to be said, I think that it's important that you understand that when you get married, it's not just moving in. It's not just, you know, moving on. It's not just having a family. It's daily and intentionally loving each other and doing that in ways that you know is beneficial for the other person. You're going to be different. You're going to have different approaches. You're going to have different ways in which you go about this. But obviously we can tell by what scripture tells us, we can tell by what C.S. Lewis had to say, that it's pretty clear that if you make it a choice, loving someone is a choice. It becomes a habit, and then it becomes overflowing at that point. So I think at this point we will do our unity candle. They decided to do a candle just to signify the importance of two families coming together. So we'll take a couple of moments to do that. So if you guys want to step over here, and we'll do that right now. The benefit of this is it's truly just a symbol. Well, I would like to tell you that this is not a bad omen, but it is not a bad omen. Perfect.
That's a pompous line.
So all the things we just discussed just happened with a candle. So hopefully now you understand the premise of what I was getting at. All right. Well, this is the point where we're gonna tell each other exactly what we're here for. You ready for this?
All right.
Ethan, I'm gonna have you repeat some words to Nicole, and these are words that you hear all the time at weddings, but they do have value. So whenever you repeat them, I do not advise you to do them lighthearted. I just recommend that when you do say these words, that you mean them and that you trust each other in what you're saying. So if you'll just repeat after me, Ethan. I, Ethan, take you, Nicole.
Take you, Nicole.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
Nicole, if you'll repeat after me. I, Nicole, take you, Ethan.
I, Nicole, take you, Ethan.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
Can we get the rings?
Thank you, Chris.
Good job, buddy. All right. So obviously, you've been at a wedding, or you've at least understood that the rings are a symbol. They represent a physical representation of your commitment to each other. They are circular in nature, and that's because it is unending. That is a fully lifetime commitment. You place the ring on the finger, you're committing that to a lifetime of each other. So if you will take that ring, Ethan, if you will place that on her finger and repeat after me. I give you this ring as a sign of my vow.
I give you this ring as a sign of my vow.
All right, Nicole, if you will do the same. Mm-hmm. If you will place the ring on his finger. If you will repeat after me. If it'll fit on his finger. I give you this ring as a sign of my vow.
I give you this ring as a sign of my vow.
Perfect. Let's pray. Father, we just thank you so much for the opportunity to share in what you brought together and what you've ultimately been in control of. Jesus, thank you so much for these two. We pray that you would be in this moment with them and that you would go forward from this moment with them. Jesus, we love you and we trust you for Ethan and Nicole both, and that their life and that their family and that their marriage moving forward will be totally based upon the trust and faith that they have in you and the direction in which you would have them go. We love you and we praise you and we pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, everybody out there is ready to get this thing going. And I think you're ready to get this going. So I guess there's only one thing left to say. I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride. If you guys want to face the crowd, I present to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Ethan Curry.
Firstly, I would like to congratulate the new Mr. and Mrs. Curry. This is a super special day, and I couldn't be happier for the both of you, truly. I've had a couple of these, so if I sound like Joe Biden, I apologize. No promises, though. Woohoo! There's a lot of people here. Ew, it's making me a little nervous. No, but surprisingly, coming into this speech, some random family member bumped into me in the bathroom and said, and I quote, "Just picture John Curry without any clothes on." John the Leopard Prince Speedo was a good call. Ethan, thank you for allowing me to be your best man and giving me the opportunity to speak upon your behalf. I can only imagine how nervous the both of you are right now. 6 years is how long I've known Ethan, and let me tell you, it's been an extremely eventful six. Crazily, it's gone by in the blink of an eye, and now my best friend is married to his beautiful bride, Nicole. We've pretty much accomplished almost everything together as a best friend duo. We started off as college drinking buddies, and now it's evolved into you being family, who I still get way too drunk with. We've laughed, we've cried, we've laughed until we've cried, we've sang, we've fought, we've kissed, and eventually made up. It's almost like I was given this giant, annoying sibling with a really gross mustache that I never asked for. However, there's nobody else I wanted to do all the things that we've done with. And I would like to say a couple of words to you, Nicole. First off, doesn't she look stunning tonight? She seriously deserves one hell of a husband. Oh, fuck, where'd my lines go? Thankfully for Ethan, she agreed to marry him before she found one. Jokes aside, if there was absolutely anybody on this planet I would want Ethan to marry, it would be you. And I honestly mean that. You're an incredible person. You're a great hang. And I've been able to be myself around you from day one and not feel as if I have ever had to impress you at any point in time. And I love you for that. Go you for marrying this bozo. It takes some serious lady balls to do that, and I applaud you for it. You're going to make an incredible wife. All right, as I wrap this speech up that I put together literally 2 hours before this wedding, I'd like to make a toast. There is nothing more noble and admirable than watching two incredible people come together, one in the unity of marriage. As your friends and family, we delight in your marriage and offer encouragement, support. Here is a toast to long life filled with adventure, love, and cherished moments.
My name is Bailey Wright, and I am Nicole's maid of honor. I met Nicole shortly after she and Ethan had started dating, over 10 years ago, which means for as long as I've known Nicole, she has loved Ethan. It's been so fun to go from Nicole telling me about her cute football player high school boyfriend to now listen to her plan her future with Ethan. Just like everyone who meets her, I instantly loved Nicole, and we became fast friends. This is where I could tell you some stories. I could tell you about the times I snuck her into bars when she was only 16, that one time in the blue light bathroom, or even the time she broke into my house, or most recently, the time I bathed her. But I promised I would not bring any of that up. So instead, I'll focus on three of my favorite things about Nicole. Number one, Nicole is the ultimate hype girl. She's always making everyone around her feel loved and special. She's the friend who will tell you how great you look even on your worst days. And she'll even chase a boy down the streets for you. So Ethan, I'm fully expecting you to be her biggest hype man every day because she deserves that. And I know you will be because she's already told me you even compliment her on her Christmas pajamas. Number two, Nicole is spontaneous. Nicole and I go on a girls' trip, just us two, every summer, and most of the time we don't really have a plan. But Nicole always reminds me that she can make an adventure out of anything and that we should make the most of any moment. Knowing you two, I have no doubt your marriage will be an adventure and that y'all will make the most of every moment. Last but certainly not least, number three, I will always remember going to listen to Nicole give her testimony one summer about her mission work in New York. Her message was clear, that as Christians, we are called to mission work, which ultimately means spreading the love of our Lord and being a beacon of his light. Anyone who knows you knows that you are a beautiful example of spreading love and being a light to everyone around you. I pray that y'all's marriage will also be rooted in the love of our Savior and that y'all's marriage will be a light to everyone. Ethan, you are so lucky because I know from firsthand experience, Nicole will celebrate your successes with you and cry through your hurt with you. She will be the best cheerleader, listener, and secret keeper. She will make you laugh, bring humor to every day, and give you every bit of her heart. I love you both, but Ethan, make no mistakes, you're still not invited on our girls' trips. Cheers.
I'm Tara. I am Nicole's cousin, but you can call us sisters more than cousins. I have had the greatest honor of watching, this girl grow up from drinking her dad's cold beer in the hot tub as a toddler to getting her ready for every single prom, homecoming, to celebrating working her ass off through nursing school and graduating and landing the best job and gaining the best friends at her job to now. And she loves my babies as her own. She has walked beside me through my joys, like delivering our fourth baby. Who knew we could get any closer than the moment that she delivered my fourth child? And many lows of life. If you even know or watch Nicole from afar, you know that she is the life of the party, and she can pretty much welcome anyone into any situation, no matter where we are. The best part of all of this celebration that we've done has watched people rally around her and celebrate her just as much as she celebrates you. And to see so many people that she loves gather around her has been the greatest honor to watch her be loved and adored as much as she loves and adores us. So it is my honor to stand next to you as you start your new chapter in life. And Ethan, I am so grateful that you're a part of our family. It took a hot minute for him to come around, that is for dang sure, Nicole would be like, okay, yeah, Ethan, my boyfriend. I'm like, mm-hmm, Ethan? Oh, I've never met him before. So, but it takes a lot of bravery to be able to come around our entire family and deal with our mess. So, we are so happy for you. We love you dearly. And we cannot wait to watch you have babies. Like, soon. And we wish you the absolute best. We love you so much. Here's to Ethan and Nicole.
On top,
it's tricky, it's tricky. Here we go, it's tricky to rock around.